hand in front of this hammer. Love, love is my Facebook friends. Peace. Well, I don't know where to start exactly. I thought we'd continue on with this. Let me give you a close-up of what's going on with the painting. I don't know how to do this exactly, so I'm gonna just that works. Alright. Basically, this was a painting lesson that I created my fiddle teacher for some lessons, for some painting lessons. Anyhow, this is for you, Charles. The composition was derived from a photograph I took one night of a late night practice of the great thing with the violin. We made a still life out of it. Now, basically, the painting is divided into different sections. When you're doing a painting, you don't want to, say you're doing a seascape, you don't want to divide the picture in half and have the sky here and the ocean here. You have to get off of that center line so that the viewer doesn't be bouncing back and forth. It's developed into a series of space breakages. I think Leonardo da Vinci developed that. With the guy with this, sitting in a circle with his hands out, the proportions. Anyhow, this is based on roughly that method. If you were to lower the horizon so that you had, this was the ocean and this was the sky, you have a better a more pleasing composition. This is called the 1:2. 1 unit of space to 2 units of space. Now you can do that with the ocean down here and the sky up here, or with the sky up here and the ocean down here. After the 1:2, you have a 2:3. 2 units of space to 3 units of space. And after that, you have the 3:5. You skip 4. 4 is back to the half and half. 5. 3 units of space to 5 units of space. You can go on and on, but it's self-defeating after 3:5. That's based on the harmonic principles, like in music. You have the root, the third and the fifth make the chord. You have the root and the dominant, the fifth, and you have the harmonics work 1, 2, 3, 5. Skip 4. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, blah, blah, blah. We don't go up into that area. But that's basically it. So it's in harmony. So we have this unit of space to this unit of space. To this unit of space. Now this one is a little bit, maybe 2.5, see? See? This is bigger than this. And then we have it down here. You could say that this is the foreground, the middle ground, and the background are subject matter, is the fiddle, which is prominently displayed in the middle ground. This is like an introduction, presentation, accompaniment. It's I'm not too good at explaining things. I'll put a little bit of white on this furl that's been bothering me. We'll put a little gray on there if we can, a little black. Yeah. That's a little better. That's a screw that tightens the bow here. We're going to add another color to the pane. I should stop right here. But all I can do is ruin the painting. And it's only the painting. So we're going to take a medium bristle bright brush. And we're going to use a new color, which includes asphalt. Asphalt is a transparent brown. Let me see if I can. I can't tip this because I spill the stuff in my cups. It's a transparent brown. All right. Now, what I'm going to attempt to do is dodging up the perimeter of the violin or fiddle, where the purfling usually goes. So we'll give that a try. And it's shaking today. Do a little stumbling here, I think. Handshakes. I should be doing C-steps, huh? With the waves. The stick is called a mall. I call it a stick or a bridge, whatever you want to call it. Sorry, my hand shakes so much, it's hard to get old. I used to do the sailing ships with all the fine rigging in it, and it takes a steady hand. If you remember on the earlier videos, I had a tough time with the strings. I had to do them a couple of times before I could get it right. It was my hand was shaking. This virus stuff has got everything messed up, and now people are getting out and about, which I don't know is such a good idea. I myself am going to stay in isolation for a while. Nobody knows what the hell this virus is doing. They only tested maybe about 3 or 4% of the population. Gotta come up with a real simple test that's fast and accurate. Trying to trying to get onto Facebook, and Facebook doesn't let me down there all the time. I don't know what's wrong with that. I'm disappointed with that. One word about Facebook is, believe only half of what you hear on there. Of misinformation. I wonder why I don't use a bigger brush. I do all over this thing. realize something. This may be considered negative space, but surrounding your object. And the breakage of the negative space is very important. It presents you the object, or your centerpiece, or whatever. Today's not such a good day for painting, shaking hands, so I think we're going to give it up for now. And we'll see what's going on here. Canvases, stretcher strips, do a big canvas, more stuff down here, more stuff, and more paint. There's a portrait I'm starting on. I always start with the eyes. Eyes are most important. The eyes make the whole picture. Get the eyes right, the rest will fall into place. Here's the backyard. Here's a bunch of canvases waiting for portraits, another palette, some paint. Another nice day in South Florida. And more stuff. Here's some past lessons. I don't know if you can see this or not. There's a lesson. Lesson. für sich. Also das. Also das. Strips, canvases, junk. I'll clean this up here, this is a mess. My niece says I'm a pig. Oink, oink. There's a bunch of mangoes fell off the tree. Another bag of them down here. There's a bad perch with a tatsy swing, aloe plants, and different stuff. All right. So the next lesson, if I do another one of these, I'm going to do something simple that you can do. Not as simple as a guy on TV. I'm not going to make happy trees and everything, but something simple that you can do is to learn something from, and you can accomplish is something easy. When you start out painting, pick a very simple subject, something simple, and do that. It builds up your confidence, and you learn how to manipulate the paints. Hold the brush like this, hold the brush like this. Yeah, I show you different things like that, and how to apply the paint. Painting is